Good morning everyone, welcome to your biology class. This video is in continuity with the previous video of the chapter Growth and Development in Plants, and the topic we are discussing is plant growth regulators. So the main objectives we are covering in this video are discovery of gibberellins, cytokinins, ethylene and abscisic acid and their physiological effects in plants. So gibberellins. Gibberellins are the plant hormones that regulate various development processes including stem elongation, germination, dormancy, flowering, flower development and leaf and fruit senescence. Gibberellins are the one of the longest known classes of plant hormone. Discovery of gibberellins. Gibberellins got their name from a fungus called Gibberella fusicuri, now called Fusarium monilifrum. This fungus caused a disease in the rice seedlings called foolish seedling disease or beccane in Japan. The infected seedlings caused the stems to become excessively tall and spindly without producing flowers. Kurosawa in 1926 isolated the fungal extract and purified the active substance. Japanese botanist in 1938 crystallized the active substance from the culture and named it as gibberellins. Now all gibberellins are acidic in nature and are usually abbreviated as GA, that is gibberellic acid, with a different subscript like GA1, GA2, GA and so on forth to distinguish one from another. GA3 means gibberellic acid 3, one of the first gibberellins to be discovered, remains the most intensively studied form. Now location. So gibberellins are present in the greatest concentration in immature seeds. They are abundant in root and shoot apices, buds, young apical leaves and young embryos. They are supposed to be transported to various parts of the plant through both xylem and phloem. Functions of gibberellins. So gibberellins perform many functions. So first is internode elongation. They bring about stem elongation by enlargement of cells. They also bring about leaf expansion but have no effect on roots. Genetic dwarf varieties of pea or corn plants can be induced to grow to normal height by the application of gibberellins. Such plants lack the hormone gibberellin genetically and so remain dwarf. Sugarcane stores carbohydrate as sugar in their stems. Spring sugarcane crop with gibberellins increase the length of the stem, thus increasing the yield by as much as 20 tons per acre. Control fruit and development. So they can induce parthenocarpy, that is development of fruit without fertilization. It has been successfully tried in pome fruits like apple and pear. Many seedlings are also being produced by acid on cabbage plant. Spraying gibberellins. Gibberellins increase the fruit size and bunch length in grapes. Now bolting in rosette plant. So some plants like cabbage and beet have number of leaves around the shoot apex and the internodal length is reduced, giving it a rosette appearance. Before flowering, such plants show bolting, that is the internodal length increases but it needs either long days or cold nights. Bolting does not occur if cabbage plant is kept at warm temperature. So by application of gibberellins, bolting can be induced even when the plant is kept at warm temperature. Otherwise, would give rise to rosette form only. Now control flowering in long day plants and modify the sex expression of certain flowers. So they promote the production of male flowers in place of female flowers in monoecious plants like cucurbits. They sometimes substitute for red light and so induce flowering in long day plants and inhibit flowering in short day plants. So gibberellins, they also helps in breaking of seed dormancy by stimulating enzyme production. Gibberellins stimulate the synthesis of an enzyme called amylase during the germination of certain seeds like cereals. As the seeds imbibes water, the embryo secretes gibberellins which diffuse to the aleurone layer. This layer produces digestive enzyme amylase which breaks down starch into glucose, and glucose is utilized for the growth of the embryo. They also stimulate the synthesis of other enzymes like proteases, lipases and ribonucleases in the seed. Then cytokininins. So discovery. The search for cytokininins spanned for several decades and involved many researchers and included substances ranging from coconut milk to fish sperm. In 1940s and 1950s, scientists tried to find a chemical substance required to stimulate the growth of cells in tissue culture. From 1954 to 1956, a scientist, Cook, identified that coconut milk contains a substance that promoted cell division in tissue cultures. At the same time, a substance from degraded samples of yeast DNA showed a similar activity. In 1963, the first naturally occurring cytokininin was chemically identified from the corn cases, lime seed. It was named zeatin. Then effect of cytokininin and auxins in cell differentiation in callus. Depending upon the ratio of auxins and cytokininins added, different responses are observed in the callus. More cytokininin and less auxin. Shoots develop. If less cytokininin and more auxin, then roots develop. Then if the intermediate concentration of cytokininin and auxins, then both the roots and shoot develop. So intermediate cytokininin and less auxin, so active mitotic divisions and callus formation takes place. Now role of cytokininins. So along with auxins, they promote cell division in the apical meristem as well as in the non-meristematic tissue. When both auxins and cytokininin are present, mitosis gets accelerated in tissue cultures of parenchyma. When only one of the hormones is present, there is no change in the activity. Then it promotes cell differentiation in cultured cells. Then reduce apical dominance. Cytokininins act antagonistically in apical dominance. Auxins stimulate apical buds and cytokininins the lateral buds. Application of both auxins and cytokininins causes complete breaking of dormancy. Then delaying of leaf senescence in plants. So cytokininins delay the normal process of aging in leaves by controlling protein synthesis and mobilization of resources. The chlorophyll does not disintegrate and so the leaves stay green. The protein synthesis also continues and carbohydrates do not break down. Cytokininins are applied to harvested vegetable crops like cabbage, lettuce, celery to extend their shelf life. They help to break the dormancy of some seeds also. Now ethylene. So discovery. So from earlier times it was known that the fruits ripen fast when kept in an enclosed paper bag or in hay or seed bags, and even an injured fruit hastens the ripening of other fruits. It has only been recently known that the ripening is due to a gaseous plant growth regulator called ethylene. Ethylene is produced in large amounts by tissues and undergoing senescence, and by ripening fruits, it surfaces in the gaseous form. Then role of ethylene. So it breaks seed and bud dormancy. It initiates germination in peanut seeds and stimulates the horizontal expansion of sprouting of potato tubers. Promotes rapid internode and petiole elongation in deep water rice plants. It helps leaves and upper parts of the shoot to remain above water. Promotes root growth and root hair formation, thus helping the plants to increase their absorption surface. It is used to initiate flowering and for synchronizing fruit set in pineapples. Also induces flowering in mango. Sex determinant in certain plants. The plants which bear male and female flowers separately, like cucumber, the application of ethylene to young buds of male flowers changes them into female flowers, antagonistic to gibberellin that produces male flowers, thereby increasing the yield. Abscission. Along with abscisic acid, it stimulates abscission of leaves. The enzymes produced by both dissolve the cell walls that hold the petiole of the leaf. Even in fruit abscission, it works along with abscisic acid. Abscisic acid discovery. So abscisic acid is a growth inhibitor and plays an important role in plant development by regulating the growth. It has been named so because it causes abscission or separation. It was discovered in 1964. It interacts with various growth promoters like auxins, gibberellins and cytokininins. Abscisic acid was originally discovered for its role in regulating abscission and bud dormancy. Role of abscisic acid. Growth inhibitor of growth and metabolism. So abscisic acid was thought to be the hormone that caused abscission of leaves and bud dormancy. It is now known that it is a growth inhibitor and reduces metabolism, and its role in abscission is not clear. It is actually ethylene that promotes senescence and abscission. Inhibits mitosis in vascular cambium at the onset of winter. Dormancy of seeds. So the dormancy of seeds is broken only when abscisic acid level in the seed reduced by increasing the level of gibberellins. It inhibits the formation of amylase in germinating cereal grains. It enables the seeds to withstand desiccation and to become dormant. Dormancy of buds. Abscisic acid induces winter dormancy by inhibiting auxins and gibberellins. The axillary buds become dormant. It stimulates the formation of dormant winter buds. As the level of abscisic acid falls in spring or summer, winter dormancy is broken. Falling of leaves and dormant buds is an adaptation to survive through cold water. Then stomatal closure. It is also known as stress hormone and brings down the closing of stomata during severe drought conditions. It increases tolerance of plant to various kinds of stress. Thank you.